The coefficient of friction at this particular point, that is TDC and BDC, will be very high because the sliding speed at this particular point. Hello guys, once again welcome back to my channel Marinertian. So guys, the topic of today's discussion is something very important for us seafarers as well as engine cadet and guys who are working on board a ship in the engine room. Before starting this video, I would like to thank ePage Designer for designing my channel art as well as channel profile. You can go to my description below and check out the link for this particular company. You can approach them for various designing related aspects like posters, channel art, channel profile, etc. The topic that we are going to discuss today is stripe back curve. The entire principle of lubrication revolves around this curve, that is our stripe back curve. Let's not waste any time, let's move on to our topic, stripe back curve. The principle of any sliding bearing is given by stripe back curve. It explains the principle of lubrication which comes under sliding contact bearing. The principle of stripe back curve are used in sleeve bearing, liner and piston, journal bearing, and we even use this principle in our cylinder lubrication. So now let's analyze this particular curve, that is our stripe back curve. Well, you can see from the graph that the x-axis represents bearing modulus, that is Zn divided by P. Well, I will be explaining the entire notation, that is Z, N and P as the video unfolds. And the y-axis represents the coefficient of friction. In the y-axis, you can see that the coefficient of friction at this particular point will be very high, and it is known as boundary lubrication. You can see very clearly in the y-axis that the coefficient of friction starts reducing and it comes to a point known as mixed lubrication, and it keeps on reducing, it comes to a point known as hydrodynamic lubrication. Well, you can see the curve in which it passes through mixed lubrication and hydrodynamic lubrication as the coefficient of friction reduces. Now we will take into consideration the example of piston and liner. We will be talking with entire cylinder oil lubrication principle connecting our stripe back curve. Now talking about the hydrodynamic lubrication present at the x-axis, that is our bearing modulus given by Z and divided by P. The oil film thickness will be high, which is separating the two metal to metal contact. In our case, piston and liner. Well, in this case, the cylinder oil thickness will be high. The principle of any sliding bearing is given by stripe back curve. No matter how smooth the surface is, there will be always asperity is present between two metal to metal contact. Well, in our case, piston and liner, there will be always asperity is present between piston and liner. And this asperity is separated by thick film lube oil in our case of hydrodynamic lubrication. In hydrodynamic lubrication, there will be always thick film of lube oil present between two metal to metal contact, in our case piston and liner. Now talking about the function of lubricant, it reduces friction, it take away the heat generated due to friction, it reduces metal to metal contact, and it is prevented by oil film of the lubricant, and you know it too have detergency property. In the hydrodynamic lubrication, you can see the graph which is present in the extreme end of the x-axis. Film of lube oil is created because of movement between two members, well in our case piston and liner. The liner is stationary and the piston will be moving from TDC to BDC. Well, because of this movement, the oil film is formed, and the oil film here reduces the metal to metal contact. Well, the stripe back curve is normally used for journal bearing. Well, it is also applicable for liner piston movement, that is in our case of cylinder lubrication. Now talking about the bearing modulus, that is our x-axis, you can see Zn divided by P. Z is the viscosity of the lubricant, N is the sliding speed. Well, in our case, it is the speed of the piston moving from TDC to BDC. P is the normal pressure, that is force per unit area. You can say it is the pressure which is pressing on the part which is moving. You can see from the graph, in the x-axis, when the bearing modulus keeps on reducing or decreasing, the coefficient of friction in the y-axis keeps on increasing. And you can see, as the bearing modulus in the x-axis keeps on increasing, the coefficient of friction in the y-axis keeps on reducing. They both are indirectly proportional to each other. Now let's analyze the sliding speed from the bearing modulus, that is n. When the piston is at TDC and BDC, the sliding speed, that is, it will be zero. So at the TDC and BDC, there will be no oil film. The coefficient of friction at this particular point, that is TDC and BDC, will be very high because the sliding speed at this particular point, that is n, is zero. Well, it is quite visible from the graph as well. When the speed is zero, the coefficient of friction will be very high. As the sliding speed increases, that is n, the oil film starts to build up. And you can see from the graph that the coefficient of friction keeps on reducing as the speed increases. So you can understand that the speed and the coefficient of friction are indirectly proportional to each other. When one keeps on increasing, that is our n, the coefficient of friction keeps on reducing. So they both are indirectly proportional to each other. As the sliding speed keeps on increasing, that is the speed of the piston, the curve reaches a region known as mixed lubrication. Upon reaching mixed lubrication, because of increment in sliding speed, that is the speed of the piston, the oil film thickness will be very high. And at this particular point, you can see it very clearly, the coefficient of friction will hit its lowest point. At this particular point, there will be hardly any contact between metal to metal, well, in our case, piston and liner. As the sliding speed keeps on increasing beyond this point, the oil film thickness will be keeping on increasing. You can understand, as the speed increases, the oil film thickness will be very high. So as the oil film thickness is very high, the bearing modulus will be also very high. As speed, that is our sliding speed n, and bearing modulus are directly proportional to each other in the x-axis. Now as the speed keeps on increasing, it reaches the hydrodynamic lubrication region, and the oil film thickness also will be very high. And you can see the curve pattern, the coefficient of friction increases upon reaching hydrodynamic lubrication region. This is due to the oil film thickness of the lubricant, because as the speed increases, the oil film thickness also will be increasing. As the oil film thickness increases, more viscous the lubricant will be. As the viscosity of lubricant increases, there will be more friction between two layers of fluid. Because of this friction generated between layers of fluid, the coefficient of friction increases in the hydrodynamic lubrication region. And as the speed increases, the oil film thickness increases and the coefficient of friction also increases, because more viscous the lubricant is. So we always try to keep the lubrication at this particular region, that is hydrodynamic lubrication. And you might also be knowing that the speed of the piston is not constant. The speed of the piston will be 0 at top dead center and 0 at bottom dead center, while the speed of the piston at the mid-stroke will be highest. So from this graph we can understand that as the sliding speed keeps on increasing, that is n, the bearing modulus will also increase. And as the bearing modulus increases, the coefficient of friction in the y-axis will reduce, because bearing modulus and coefficient of friction are indirectly proportional to each other, while the bearing modulus and the sliding speed, that is n, are directly proportional to each other. So you can also say that as sliding speed keeps on increasing, the coefficient of friction in the y-axis will drop. That's all I want to talk about Stivett curve. I feel Stivett curve is very interesting topic, because the entire principle of lubrication revolves around Stivett curve. I hope this video was quite informative and interesting one too. If you liked the video, guys, give us a thumbs up. Guys, don't forget to press the subscribe button and press on the bell icon for future notifications, and share with your friends as well. And yeah guys, do comment down below in the comment section, as it is helping me to improvise my videos in the YouTube channel. So this is Mariner Sheehan signing off. Thank you and have a nice day.